Life is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to rise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Tell me something. Why do you come to school earlier than everyone else every day?
I get here early, but not as early as you.
I really thought you wouldn't last 3 days in our kung fu class.
Oh, you did.
I was wrong about you.
So stop being such a male chauvinist, okay?
Oh, my ever dearest Miss Linda.
Yes?
Would you allow me to invite you to lunch later?
Oh, wait a minute. Are the others coming?
It'll just be you and me.
Oh.
What do you say?
Just us?
Well?
Okay.
All right. I'll treat you after our kung fu class today at the Space Needle restaurant.
Okay. I just have to change. I won't be long. Wait for me.
Okay, just a minute, Linda. Say hi to your mom for me.
Of course. Wait for me here, okay? Hi, Mom.
Hello, sweetheart. You're early today. Linda? Linda? Why are you half an hour earlier than usual? You seem to be in a good mood. Tell me, do you have any pleasant surprise for me?
Mom, you're like a policeman with all these questions. Just because I'm in a good mood doesn't mean I have a pleasant surprise for you.
About you because you're a young woman now. Wait, why are you all dressed? Are you going out?
Yes, Ma.
Oh, who invited you out on a date?
No one. A friend just asked me out. We're going to the city to get a bite to eat.
Oh, all right. You all be careful, okay?
Thank you, Ma. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Hi.
Hi. Sorry you had to wait so long.
That's okay. It was well worth the wait.
Come on.
should go out more often then. Let's go in. This way, ma'am.
It's beautiful. I've never eaten in a place this high before.
Me too. It's kind of like being in outer space, don't you think?
Outer space? That's an exaggeration, but it is nice here.
In a place like this, you can't help but smile.
Ready to order, sir?
Yes. We'd like to order 2 servings of space food?
You need an astronaut's ID, sir.
Oh, I left it in the space pod. We had to make an emergency landing on the moon yesterday, hmm?
Sorry, sir.
Steak medium rare, please.
Very well, ma'am. How about you, sir?
I'd like to have the same, please.
Bruce, you don't have to order the same thing.
It's okay, I'm avoiding putting sugar in my tea.
You're too funny.
2 orders, please.
2 orders of steak, medium rare. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Your sense of humor doesn't seem to be suited for philosophy.
Oh, someone once asked a TV genius, Dr. Charles Stamens, what branch of science would develop the fastest in 25 years? Dr. Stamens answered the question right away. His answer was, that will be spiritual perception. Did you know, Linda, that if a person realizes a spiritual power inside his own body, and if he uses that spiritual power in science, in business, or in his lifestyle, there will be no stopping him. He will surely be successful in life. You know what? In studying philosophy, I feel I have a spiritual power deeper than any of my beliefs in life, higher than all of my dreams, broader than my imagination, and stronger than the confidence in myself. It's like a combination and mixture of all the good things that we can have for ourselves. Now, if I can nurture the spiritual power in my mind will surely be open to so much knowledge about life.
That was really deep. But you know, I admire your confidence, Bruce.
I feel like from the moment I was born, I had confidence in myself. Linda, do you know what my dream is?
You dream that one day, everyone in America and even in the whole world will come to know and respect Chinese Kung Fu. Isn't that it?
Wow, it's like you read my mind.
Your heart's the one that's easy to read.
Oh, that's dangerous. Maybe I should lock the door of my heart. But I'll take the key and give it to someone. Can I give that key to you? Hold on to it for me.
Me?
Your order, ma'am.
Thank you.
Here's your steak, sir.
Thank you.
Enjoy your meal.
Go on, ladies first.
Can I give you a suggestion?
I'm all ears.
Lots of people cook hamburgers here in America, but it was McDonald's that made the world understand about hamburgers.
Okay.
What I mean is, why are you giving free kung fu classes on campus? Why don't you open a legitimate kung fu school outside the university? One where people will pay to learn kung fu. Maybe your school can become like McDonald's. Because of your school, everyone will understand what kung fu is. You'll fulfill your dream and make money too.
Chain of kung fu schools? That's a good idea, Linda. I mean, think about it. Each state could have its own Chinese kung fu school. Wow, I'm so excited about the future of martial arts.
I'm glad.
Terrific idea.
Well, you look like a kid who got a new toy.
Linda, you're different from all the women I've met. Your ideas, they pull me closer to you. What I mean by by destiny. Two people who have to be together forever can never be parted because God put them together.
Really?
You can't escape.
It looks that way.
Kimura?
Bruce, I've been waiting for you.
Hold on a minute. Come with me.
I have something to show you.
What is it?
Just come with me.
Where are we going?
You'll like it. You'll find out in a bit.
Huh?
Trust me.
What are you talking about?
You'll like this.
What is this place?
Go in. I estimate you can teach Kung Fu to about 30 students at a time here. Isn't it your dream to have a Kung Fu house? Here it is. You now have a Kung Fu house.
You sold your tea house? Didn't I tell you not to? I told you not to sell your tea house just for me.
You had nothing to do with it. It was my decision.
Nothing to do with it? You sold your tea house just so I could open a Kung Fu house. Take this back. I won't accept it.
Bruce, you have dreams for your life. I do too. It was never my dream to put up a tea house. I want something else.
I know. That's enough, Kimura. If I accept this, I'll always feel uncomfortable about it. So I don't want to accept this. Never, not ever.
But Bruce, I signed the contract. I already paid 6 months' rent. What will I do now?
Sorry, but that's your problem. I told you, I won't allow you to do this. No Kung Fu house will be put up here. Bruce, wait!
Bruce, I didn't do this just to help you. This is for me too. My tea house. It did okay money-wise. A lot of my countrymen, a lot of Japanese, used to come there. But when you became my master, they stopped coming. I've been losing customers. Sooner or later, I would be forced to close down the tea house. It's better that I sell it off now. Better than waiting to lose money and eventually go bankrupt. So I use some of the money to rent this place The rest of it, we can use to buy equipment and pay the utilities. When that happens, our dream of having a kung fu house will become a reality. Bruce, I know you don't like to accept help or charity from other people. I understand, but I'm not other people. You're my teacher, and I'm your student, and your friend too. Don't worry though, I'm not giving it to you for free. I'm just lending it. So you'll have to give it back. When you start making a lot of money, you'll pay me back. Kimura, I'm so glad that I have such a friend. A friend like you. The annoying thing is, you made me eat my words again. Don't worry. Whether I succeed or not, I will pay you back all I owe you. I promise you that. Bruce, I know you're going to succeed.
Good morning, Ma. I see you're awake, darling. Good morning. Breakfast?
Thank you, Mom.
So who is the Asian guy?
Asian guy?
Yes, the guy who brought you home yesterday when you went out.
Oh. That was Bruce, Mom. Interesting character. I have to go, Ma.
Wait, darling. Mm-hmm. Don't go just yet. Tell me a little of his background first.
Well, he's teaching us a special Chinese dance at school.
Well, may I meet this friend of yours?
I don't know if he'll agree to that.
Why wouldn't he? He's come to the house already. He just didn't come in.
You were spying on us?
No, of course not. I just glanced out the window.
Ma, bye.
May I speak with you? Look, E10, I know that we've had our differences, but let's put that aside for now. Please listen to me. I have a message for Mr. Yamamoto. Bruce Lee would like to face him in a fight, a friendly fight. In Wushu, we should always share our skills and knowledge. It's good for us to develop ourselves. If we just think of this as a fight we have to win, it loses its meaning. We stray away from the real objective of martial arts.
Don't try to teach me, Kimura, because I teach martial arts. If you want to debate with me, you're not going to win. But first, we're going to have to clean up the shame you have brought upon us. Kimura, you'd better tell that Chinese master of yours. He will lose face among the people of Seattle and all of America. You will both fail.
It's true. My master is Chinese now. I'm learning Chinese Kung Fu, from which the art of Wushu originated. I don't want to fight. I don't want to make this worse, this conflict between us.
That's enough, Kimura. Enough with your explanations. Just tell that master of yours he'd better be ready.
Did Kimura call again?
Yes, master. He has called several times. He wants to talk to you.
Oh, he must be very scared.
What he is afraid of now is that you might paralyze his master.
This early, let's look for a place. There has to be a lot of witnesses to see Bruce Lee lose. Let's not allow that Chinese guy to boast anymore. Here in America, we'll make sure there's no place for him.
Yes, master. Do not worry. We will find the right opportunity.
Good. Put up the Iron Man. Go ahead.
Hi.
Oh.
We have almost all the equipment we need now. So next Saturday, I think we can begin to recruit students. Kimura.
I was thinking, since we're just starting out, shouldn't we lower our tuition fee a little bit?
Lower it? I don't think so. That's the minimum already. We charge the lowest among the martial arts schools. Even if we get 30 students, we have to subtract the rental for the place, equipment depreciation, and taxes, so only a little will be left for us. So if we lower the tuition fee, we'll lose money. We won't have enough to pay for utilities.
All right. Next week, we can open our Kung Fu house, okay? This is what I designed as our house logo. What do you think?
This is good. It's kind of philosophical.
Hey!
Hi,
all
Jesse.
Of our equipment arrived from Hong Kong.
Really?
Have them bring them in.
Tell them to bring it all
right.
Inside.
Hey, kids! Bring that in. Put that in over there. Okay, be careful with that.
Bruce,
careful, those are heavy.
Why do you look nervous?
Do it carefully.
Easy, easy. Watch. I was just thinking, it's our first step.
Okay.
To fulfill a dream I've had for so long time.
Okay. Over here.
What if no one wants me as a teacher?
Based on how you want against me, you're now famous. You're known to all of Seattle.
But it's hard. Hard to believe that my dream is actually coming true.
Hey, be careful with that.
Sorry.
All right, if you break it, you pay for it. Come on.
Jesse, that's the woodman's stake. The pieces of wood are really separate.
Woodman's stake?
Yes, woodman's stake. In Hong Kong, when we practice Chinese Kung Fu, we have to have a woodman's stake. It's an important piece of equipment. Watch me. I'll show you how this is used. Go ahead. I haven't used this in a while.
Wow.
Bruce, no wonder your kung fu is different. You used to have one of these.
It's your turn. Give it a try.
Me, can I try it?
Sure.
All right, stand by.
You got caught that time. You'll learn its characteristics as you practice. You can't use a great amount of force on this.
Wow, really?
You have to follow the power of the wood. Like this. So you don't get hurt. Understand?
Yes, I got it.
Jesse, put this over there. It's to lock the wood.
I'll do it.
Hi, Linda. What's up?
Can I talk to you, Bruce?
Sure, of course.
My mom said she'd like to meet you.
Really?
Sorry, it's just that she's worried about me.
Maybe she doesn't want us to be together.
She's just worried you won't be able to support me.
Don't worry about that, Linda. That's not going to happen. Our Kung Fu house is all set up now. We all start charging those who want to study with us. When we get more students and when Kung Fu becomes really well known, we'll surely earn a lot of money.
I know that.
Please tell your mom for me. I will go to your house to meet her, but not right now. It's not the time.
Master Yamamoto, we now have a chance to introduce you to the whole of Seattle.
What is this? How do we do that?
It's like this. Every year here in Seattle, there's an Asian festival. It's a showcase for the different cultures of Asia. With the help of the Chinese community, they set up booths and sell various items.
What does that have to do with us? That's just a commercial event.
Many people attend, Master. A lot of Asian countries take part in it. Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Korea, even the Japan Business Group, they all join the event. There are also different performances. Master Yamamoto, it would be a good chance A chance for you to become known among the people of Seattle. It's the perfect opportunity to show off your expertise in martial arts. If you agree, Master, I'll take care of the paperwork.
I came here for two things. One was to open a karate school, and the other to beat Bruce Lee at martial arts.
Hey. I guarantee you will defeat Bruce Lee. But what is more important is that you will be known to the people of Seattle. Along with that, the influence of karate will increase.
Hmm. Go ahead. All right. Take care of it right away.
Hey.
You look happy. Did you get some good news or something?
I was going to ask you to postpone tomorrow's opening.
Postpone?
Yes.
But why? We set that date a long time ago. Everything's ready. Why should we postpone the opening?
Wait, Kimura. Next month, there will be an Asian cultural festival here in Seattle.
Asian cultural festival? But what does that have to do with our Kung Fu house?
Bruce, that will be a good opportunity. Think about it. Your Chinese Kung Fu is known on campus, but only a few people outside of campus know about it. If you perform at the festival, a lot more people will be interested to enroll in Kung Fu classes.
Are you trying to say you want me to attend the festival so that people will learn about Chinese Kung Fu?
Exactly. God is giving you the chance.
But the Asian festival, it's 2 weeks away.
That's why I suggested it to you. We still have time to prepare, and the process won't take that long.
We would become known through that kind of festival, but our opening tomorrow. And the Asian cultural festival you're talking about, Linda, those are two different things.
They're really not. They're not two different things, Kimura. It's a good business opportunity. It'll be more impressive and more people will know about it if we have the opening of the Kung Fu house on the same day as the festival.
But then again, we've already picked an opening date. If we change it, it may be unlucky.
What do you mean?
All right. I think it's hard for you to understand because we're talking about two different cultures here. But Kimura, let's consider this. Linda's making some valid points. If we can use his festival to, like she said, it would be good publicity for our Kung Fu house.
Okay, you said it.
Yes!
There's nothing I can do. Anyway, I'm outvoted. So, we delay our opening.
Good. This'll be good.
Here's your coffee.
Thanks, Mom.
What is that you're typing? Are you writing the president's inaugural address? Huh?
No, Mom, I'm filling out an application.
Oh. What is this, a Chinese newspaper? So that means you're helping the young man from China. May I borrow this a moment?
What? Go ahead, Ma. That will lessen your prejudice against Chinese people.
Prejudice? I don't have prejudices against anyone, darling.
Project proposal and application for the festival.
Oh, okay. Have a seat. Oh, I'm so sorry, miss. As of now, we've already accepted a number of martial arts performances for the festival.
What? Wait, please read our project proposal first. If you read it, I'm sure you'll love it.
It doesn't matter, because it already passed the cutoff date for the submission of applications.
Would it be possible for you to extend it?
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
Oh.
Don't be discouraged. You can always join next year. We hold the Asian Cultural Festival every year. Next time, make sure to submit your application early so it'll be considered ahead of schedule.
Thank you. Bye.
You're welcome. Let's discuss this later. Our chief secretary just came in. I have to report to her. Bye. Did you forget something, miss?
I just wanted to ask something about the submission of proposals.
Just make it fast. We're very busy. She's inquiring about the festival.
Is there a problem?
Miss Shu is our secretary general. You can ask her your question.
Thanks. Hi, ma'am.
Hello.
If I'm not mistaken, we've met before.
Really?
Yes, ma'am. I think it was at the Ruby Shoe restaurant.
That's probably it. I'm the owner. Hello. I'm Ruby Shoe.
Oh, hi, I'm Linda.
I'm also the Secretary General of the Chinese Businesses in Seattle. So tell me, what can I do for you?
Okay. I applied for a spot in the Asian Cultural Festival. We wanted to introduce Kung Fu to Seattle. Kung Fu is a kind of Chinese martial art.
Chinese Kung Fu?
Ma'am Ruby, I told her our martial arts program is already filled. We have Japanese karate, Korean taekwondo, so we cannot accommodate them in the festival. It will be hard.
It's okay. Let's listen to her first. Go ahead.
Thanks.
It's Linda, right? I don't know if I can help you, but who is your performer?
Oh, I included that in our project proposal. Here it is, ma'am. His name is Bruce Lee, but he's not that well known yet.
Bruce Lee? Is his Chinese name Lichao Wang? If Bruce Lee's the one to perform, I will not reject your application.
Oh, really?
But Ma'am Ruby, we no longer have any space in the festival to give them.
Oh no, that's okay. We don't need a big space for the performance. All we need is a little corner that
will
be
We'll have a place for you. Please tell Bruce Lee. The people of Seattle are excited to see him. I'm excited to see his performance myself.
Oh, really? Oh, thank you so much for helping us, Ma'am Ruby. Oh, here's our proposal, ma'am.
This looks very good.
Oh, thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much for your help. I'll leave that with you. Thank you very much again. Bye.
This is great! You know what, Linda? I feel as if I will never be apart from you. You're a part of my future.
Bruce, do you want to know how I feel about you?
Certainly. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you.
That's okay. At least to save me from this guy. Oh, I almost forgot. What do you think of this for our flyer?
Chinese Kung Fu. Wow, this is great. Thank you, Linda. You're so wonderful. This is perfect. All right.
Bruce?
I found out that Bruce Lee is also performing at the festival.
In the Asian Cultural Festival?
Hey, that's what the secretary of the organizers told me.
That's good news. I can show people my skills, how good I am. The people of Seattle will also witness the fall of that Chinese.
Master, are you going to challenge him to a fight?
I don't have a challenge. I just want you all to watch a good show and have fun.
Listen, ladies and gentlemen. Today you will see the pride in the hero of Seattle. No one can beat him when it comes to Kung Fu. Watch out for the performance of Bruce Lee later today. Here, take this.
Can I have more?
Oh, sure. Here.
Linda, why did they give us a place so far from the festival proper?
Kimura, don't complain anymore. If not for Linda's efforts and for Ma'am Ruby's help, we wouldn't even have a place in this festival, you know? Give out more flyers.
But you're right. We're kind of hidden in this spot. Don't worry, Kimura. I'll pull in some people from the surrounding areas.
Nice and pretty, but will it work in a real fight? Maybe it's all just for show.
It looks to me, sir, like you have some experience in the field of martial arts.
I have some experience. I used to be a boxer.
Oh, really, sir?
And I spent 8 years in the army. Would you like to try me?
All right, sir. I've been wanting to have someone to spar with. If you'd like to sweat a little, come up here with me on the stage. Come on up, sir. Hey, that, sir, is Chinese Kung Fu.
Great. That's really great.
If you'd like to learn Chinese Kung Fu, just go to the address written on the flyers and sign up for classes. Mr. Bruce Lee will teach you. Let's give another round of applause for Mr. Bruce Lee.
What's your name?
My name is Yamamoto.
I've been waiting for you. I'm glad you're finally here.
I see we've been thinking of the same thing. Use all your skills and knowledge, Bruce Lee. I heard you're full of yourself. You told people there's no one who can beat you here in Seattle. Is that true?
That's true. I did say that.
Good then. Because today I will make you eat your words and I will teach you a lesson you will never forget.
Good. Go ahead and try.
You as a karate master. Don't let yourself be shamed by that kind of behavior. That's not good. Please, sir.
I want to teach that boastful Chinese kid a lesson he'll remember.
This is not a contest. If you want to engage in a real fight, make it official. Send us a letter saying you are challenging Bruce Lee to a fight.
Wait, who are you?
I sell medicinal herbs.
He's a hawker.
Bruce Lee! Now you've had a taste of the real power of karate. There is no place for you here in Seattle. Get out of here!
Shalom! Bruce, it's enough.